using that, but just FYI, they're in there if you want to use them. So 147s, I apologize that I'm going to be saying a bunch of stuff, and just try to follow what you can follow, because I know it's going to just be all new. But we want a big flame annealing flame. And even though this is borosilicate, I always treat it nicely and gently, as I would like to be treated. So I'm just warming this in, and you can see the condensation of the water that is present. See how on the edges of where the heat is licking, how the flame is splashing wide. It's called the jet wash. Maybe we can see. So we want to just kind of warm that in, so that, you know, sometimes you'll get condensation buildup in particular on the end. Thank you. Is that any better? No? Yeah. Maybe we could turn those off. I don't know. Tell me if that doesn't work, having these lights off. Maybe kick the lights off. Is that too dark?
It's not too dark. It's a little darker, but the
still okay.
Light from the window helps.
Okay, so I warm it in. This is longer than I normally warm it in because I'm talking. When I'm starting to add my oxygen in, I go to the back, and I get to a nice long reducing flame, and I just warm it here for a second too. I'm not even really in the flame, see that? I'm like off the back end of the back of my flame guide. And then I just let it kind of get happy molecularly. You know, I kind of like soften it up, you know? Like, you don't want to just jump into the... Right. Actually, I do like jumping in cold water, because I don't want to dip my toe in, because then I just get scared. So that analogy doesn't work,
that's
actually.
A real nice shock.
Huh?
But if you jump in cold, it's a real nice shock.
It is.
Which causes cracks.
This one would cause cracks. It would not be beneficial. So anyway, we just want to go nice and slow. My hand position is over-under, but it can be over-under. And it can be over-over, and it can be under-under, and it should be able to be all of those things. See how now I'm moving? Right? So I want to support this, and what you need to know and remember is the onion. So I want this heat to soak, not just warm the outside, I want it to soak to the inside. So when I start to see my tube look orange in on the interior as well as the exterior, which people like to short and not give it the proper amount of time because it starts to move like a liquid and they freak out because their hands don't know how to control it and they're just like, ugh, I need to pull it! And then they prematurely pull it and then they get this wompy thing. So you gotta work at the edge of the flame heat that allows you to stay in here and be comfortable. So if I back out, I'm softer and slower back here, right? It's a lot easier. So I back out of the flame so I don't get a hot spot, and I pull. I'm used to pulling bigger tubing. That's why I pulled really fast at the beginning to reduce my diameter size right at the start, which I didn't need to do for this. Because actually I'd want to pull slow right from the beginning to maintain that big diameter because of how small this tube diameter is. And then I go back in, just use the top, use my flame. Use the top of my flame and fire cup. I always, when I'm idling and not using my flame, I turn it off. Turn off my oxygen, that is. The oxygen we burn through really quickly. This clanking drives me nuts. So if you're in that same camp, I'm sorry. I started to try to wear it as a, that's not a good solution. Tried to wear it as a, around a necklace, and then the necklace, when I work bigger, gets, the thing burns me. Deal with it. I'm starting to become like a, I'm married, and that's nice. Every time, every rotation, I'm reminded. So these generally cool off pretty quickly. If you try to work quicker than they are cool, and you burn your fingers, then quickly that it was too hot, and you can do that without actually touching it. You catch your air to cool it down, and if you're in a hurry, that helps speed things up. If you're patient, then you don't have to worry about it. So this is an application where it's important to have one of these. Usually after I make that first pull, I then use this, which allows me to hold up here and get nice heat and make a pull. Don't forget, write this down, 247s when you're making, or 147, or you guys are gonna be doing tubing 147 in this one, so you don't have to worry about it. But you wanna make sure that your end is open. So this will be a technique that you need in 147, is just a soft score line. If you go heavy on these, you can you can have a nice cut surprise. Same thing, break into the weak side of the point, so the score line should be away from you, and push with your thumb on either side of it. And then fire polish that end so you don't cut your mouth when you're using it to blow. And notice I'm in a really soft reducing flame here, so I don't close that hole off. I'm just rounding off my edges. All right, so I'm not quite sure how I did. Looks all right. We'll find out. So it kind of, what happens is it can accentuate. If you get off on one point, then the next one you pull will be off subsequently even a little bit more because it's referencing where you're turning from, which is off. So everything kind of follows that line, that sequence. Now I'm adjusting my flame height. I'm only using my center flame on this stuff because that's what you guys are going to be using. But normally I would adjust a little bit. So I'm pre-warming here. This one's a little bit more important even than the past one where I was using the flame annealing flame to warm up my tube. Because of the way that it is introduced is less consistent, is less it has the chance of heating unevenly, I guess, a little bit more. And you'll get cracks if you try to just go into a direct flame on this a lot more readily than heating down the middle of a tube like I just did. So see how I kind of back out as I introduce the oxygen? And I'm just touching the edge of my flame. And then I'm facing a little bit in on my edge. I don't want to see my condensation back here. I don't want to really bear down into it like that because it'll start heating my hand up. The heat of the flame will go all the way down the tube and give you a nice wake-up call. So you want to be, you know, I'm letting my flame lick on the back of my tube. So it's hitting back here, hand up in the front, and it's splashing across the face of my tube, so that, see my heat color start to come in? I'm orange in my end, and you'll start to see this tube here, like from here over, will also start to show some heat color. Most of the time on bigger tubing, I pull this down by using an old point, so I just punky up to it with the end of an old point, because it's a bigger diameter and it's easier to grab. And normally, again, I don't use stuff that's this short, but because I just cut it, I'm going to, so I don't waste it. So if you, there are a number of ways of getting here, basically, but if you keep heating, this will just close down on its own. But I can take my paddle, and I'm using it above my flame and just putting a little pressure on that to reduce my diameter. The graphite can handle the heat okay. Metal does not like to be in the flame at all. Don't use your metal in the flame, you'll ruin it. Graphite is pretty resilient. It's basically just carbon. And then I'm gonna punty. So notice I'm building my heat up first before I punty, because if I have my heat set, it's basically ready to pull. The heat is ready to pull. It's a liquid. I touch it, I get something that I can pull with, and then I, you know, take a second to even my heat out, and then I come out and make my pull. So I'm choking up on my tube so I have a little bit easier control right here. Make sure you don't grab where you just pull the point. That'll also wake you up. So I touch my back.